Hi, my name's David Barber, and I'm a supervising sound editor and re-recording mixer at Juniper Post in Burbank, California.
Hi, I'm Alexey Lukin, iZotope's principal DSP engineer and a longtime developer of RX.
Whoa, okay.
Wow, a few different types of noises here. What?
10 minutes. All right. Well, let's get into it. Good luck, Alexey.
I'm up for challenge.
All right, let's give this thing a listen here.
Oh, wow, definitely, on the fly. I never prepare a DJ set. I select my music, I choose my music, but what happens during a DJ set, it's...
Counting down.
All right, let's get it started. Interesting. So I'm even wondering if this whole thing is in mono or stereo.
So first I'm going to run it through what I call the usual suspects. So I'm just going to run that.
This is quite revealing. I can see that in the right channel there is a lot of flyover noise and a little bit of dialogue, whereas in the left channel it's primarily dialogue.
The other thing that I'll do is go to the paintbrush tool and kind of follow along with the lines.
What can we do next? I think this flyover sound is non-stationary. It means if I zoom on frequency, it will probably change in frequency a lot.
I'm going to increase the strength because we really want to go at these things, so.
I will try maybe minus 20 dB of reduction.
Another thing that I want to do is go kill some birds here.
Whenever I'm looking for birds, I'm looking for harmonics at the upper frequencies that are sort of islands of energy.
A lot of the times there'll be a repeated chirp.
Oh no, more birds.
So I'll select it and I'm going to use Find Similar and see what it does.
Oh, and more birds here. I'm not sure if I have time to fix them all.
Now I'll go in using Attenuate. I will try to get rid of these guys.
Some of the birds are very hard to catch.
Okay. D-click.
This sort of diagonal chirp looks suspicious to me.
All right, how are we doing on time? Hands up. I guess that's what we get.
Hey, Dave, how did you do?
I feel pretty good about it. How about yourself?
It was pretty tight for me. I was catching all those birds.
Yeah, I kind of wanted to keep going, but, you know, time limits are time limits. It's like the real world, I guess. Here, I'll do a quick before and after.
Oh, wow, definitely, on the fly. I never prepare a DJ set. I select my music, I choose my music, but what happens during a DJ set, it's... Oh, wow, definitely, on the fly. I never prepare a DJ set. I select my music, I choose my music, but... What happens during a DJ set, it's...
Wow, sounds pretty clean.
Yeah, obviously their biggest problem is that airplane that's flying through. To start with, I kind of have a usual suspects module chain that I use. Mouth, D-click, dialogue isolate, D-plosive, and then another dialogue isolate that I usually restrict to 500 hertz and below. And then I went in and started to attack the airplane, and I started by using D-hum on the dynamic setting, and then I restricted the bands to just kind of below 1K where most of the plane sound was. For the stuff before the voice, it worked out pretty well, but then obviously as the Doppler starts to slide through the vocal frequencies, you can't really get an accurate sample. So then I went into my old-fashioned surgical mode using spectral repair. And I set it to vertical interpolation, I set the bands to 4096 and slide the surrounding region length all the way down to 25, and I increased the strength up to 2. So I went through and I just paintbrushed in between all of those, and in some of the lower frequencies I used the lasso tool and I just deleted what I had lassoed out. In the grand scheme of things, you don't miss that little particular sliver of sound. Later on, I used gain reduction. I'd lasso something and I would just turn it down 5 or 10 dB so that it would push farther into the back of the sonic image. And then his voice was very edgy between 500 and 1.5K. So I just used EQ and did a little scoop on that. And then attacked some birds. There were some birds just beyond the voice that are free and clear. So I would use the lasso tool and kind of circle the frequencies of the birds and then use Find Similar. And I set that to 0.2 because I wanted to find a lot of them. And then spectral repair on vertical interpolation, where it grabs from above and below and replaces the bird with what hopefully should be there, like voice.
Has Find Similar been able to find any birds during speech or just after speech?
No, it definitely finds it within, which is great. But generally, they're in that 5K to 15K range. So if you use the vertical interpolation on spectral repair, you'll be sampling from above and below your selection. So it'll be replacing an S or an F with human voice and removing the bird at the same time.
This is awesome. I'm seeing that you're very, very familiar with different RX selection tools and are actually taking time to explore them.
That's where I always start with the rectangular and see how far I can get. I like to zoom in because when you get in that close, then you can really start to see stuff. And the more you work with audio, the more you'll start to recognize, yeah, that shouldn't be there, that shouldn't be there, that shouldn't be there. That's it. How about you? What'd you come up with?
Here is my final result.
Oh, wow, definitely, on the fly. I never prepare a DJ set. I select my music, I choose my music, but what happens during a DJ set, it's...
Well, first of all, I noticed that it sort of sounds mono to me, not stereo. So I went to Spectrum Analyzer and noticed that it also looks mono. Then I explored it further and I've applied the mixing tool with this MS encoder decoder preset, which converts left, right to mid side. And as soon as I looked into this, I saw that there is a lot of noise in the side channel here at the bottom, and a little bit of dialogue leakage as well. Most of the dialogue is concentrated in the mid channel, so maybe we could just down mix to mono. But I went a few steps further and I've just selected this side channel, copied it and tried to subtract it with invert and paste into the mid channel a couple of times, and I saw that those lower harmonics are slightly reduced, not fully gone, because apparently the helicopter was decorrelated between left and right, it wasn't like fully mono. And then I just took this left channel, which is the mid channel, and copied it into a separate file to work on it and see if we can just kill all the sides and whether it helps or not. I also tried dynamic de-hum. I do like dynamic de-hum a lot, so we are similar in this respect. I tried to train it on this isolated section of the helicopter sound. Predictably, it didn't work very well in the remainder of the file because the helicopter sound goes down, but it killed a little bit of this hum in the beginning. And then I used my standard tool, dialogue isolate, as you mentioned. I think it got rid of significant portion of the helicopter sound and even the birds, as well as all the static wideband noise. And then I tried to follow up with a few isolated de-humps on a couple of lower frequency rectangular selections here to get rid of some of the remaining helicopter sounds after de-hum. After that, I started looking for birds. I hidden the waveform, only displayed the spectrogram, and started looking for those, you know, wiggles at the upper middle frequencies. Here is one, here is more, and maybe this as well. Any sort of isolated islands of energy there are uncharacteristic for voice, but they are very characteristic of the birds. And I can just show you a few selections. So I haven't thought about using Find Similar tool for those birds because I thought that maybe the birds are different. That was a good idea. I should try it next time. And after that, I've noticed that there is a little bit of what sounded to me like a lavalier microphone rustle. I again used spectral repair, attenuate mode in the vertical or horizontal mode, depending on where I see more similar stuff. So I went through some of those lavalier microphone rustles one by one because I felt like maybe it's not worth running the whole pass of de-rustle in this entire clip. Finally, I compensated for the gain change that the mid-side encoder decoder did, and also to get rid of that clipping on playback. All right, awesome to see you in work, Dave. Hope to see you working more.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to more samples to see what we can dig into.
Absolutely. Take care.
You too.